At the Academy Award ceremonies this past week, it seemed that the veteran actors outshone all the rest. But with John Wayne and Gig Young both winning Oscars, and with Cary Grant receiving a special award and a film review of the highlights of his long career, well, Monitor continues this trend, and we have one of the great film stars of all time, Jimmy Stewart, as our guest. Jimmy, like Cary Grant, you're primarily considered as the good guy type. I don't recall you ever playing a heavy in your long career.
I did. I played.
What'd you play?
I played the murderer in the second Thin Man picture with Bill Powell and Myrna Loy. I was, of course, in those Hammett stories. You know, the real murderer is the fellow that you least expect, and I was the fellow that they least expect, and I'd done it, and they caught me and threw me out of the window and killed me.
Hmm. So you're a bad guy, a one-time shot kind of bad guy.
Yes, I didn't care too much for the part.
You won an Oscar nomination for your role as a protester in Mr. Smith Goes to Washington. How do you feel about the current day protesters?
Well, I give that example that you just stated there a lot of times when some of the protesters come to me and say, why are you establishment and why are you always making movies and saying things that are sort of pro-establishment?
Well, Mr. Smith was
anti-establishment.
No question about it, boy.
And I've made several of those. I made a picture of, later on than that, after the war, a picture called It's a Wonderful Life. I was anti-establishment. I was against the banker in town and against the real estate developers, and I was anti-establishment there. I was for the little fella.
Mm-hmm. One of your most successful films, Anatomy of a Murder, was a forerunner to all the permissiveness in the movies. Remember that they had trouble getting a seal for the film. They used words like, words that had never been used before, rape and mm-hmm. so forth. If you'd known you were contributing to this trend, would you have appeared in that film?
Yes. I really never have felt that it contributed to a trend like that. I admit that Otto Preminger convinced me of this, but I felt that the story, the essence of that drama was good enough to necessitate a lot of the things that we said, a lot of the material that it was about. I don't think that stuff was dragged in. I think it was an integral part of the telling of the story, and so I never thought that was bad.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's one of the big troubles today. I mean, I think that if you have a picture, whether it's doing well or not, if you have a picture, and you have this tremendous shock thing in it, the sensationalism, if you take that out and don't have anything left, don't have any humor left, don't have anything of dignity, don't have any quality in the picture, then I don't think you're doing a good job. Then I think you're relying on a sort of a material, undramatic, really, thing, and you're not doing a good job. Mm-hmm. You're not doing the right kind of a job.
Well, you've been doing the right kind of job throughout your career, Jimmy, and you'll be doing all of us a great favor if you'll just keep on making movies. Our guest, Jimmy Stewart, in 1 minute, a report.